This line of drab sheds is hiding the bare bones of a great British spectacle.
They may look very plain now, but in a couple of weeks' time, these will be transformed into one of the most colourful events in the country. Forget the Notting Hill Carnival, this is the Spalding Tulip Parade.
It takes more than 100,000 tulip heads to decorate each float, and it all started back in the late 1950s to celebrate the booming British tulip industry. But flat eastern England is a very long way away from the natural habitat of wild tulips, which are native to cool, mountainous regions, especially from Iran to northwest China.
Their name comes from the Persian word meaning turban, and these brightly coloured flowers were first cultivated in the Turkish Ottoman Empire.
But it was the Dutch who became obsessed with breeding them, and in the 1630s they succumbed to tulip mania. The value of bulbs soared, and it's believed at one time a single specimen could buy you an entire townhouse on Amsterdam's most fashionable canal. The British tulip industry only began in 1907 with 100 bulbs bought to Spalding from the Netherlands. But since the 1980s, it's been in decline, outcompeted by the Dutch, who have developed a mastery of tulip production few can rival. But one grower in Norfolk is making a stand. Belmont Nurseries grows millions of tulips for British supermarkets every year, and they go to surprising lengths to get their blooms just right.
None of these will actually be picked for the flower. We will take the heads off of these flowers.
Just the heads?
Just the heads.
Why?
That way, all of the energy from that green leaf goes back down into that bulb to produce a far better, stronger bulb for us to use in the glasshouses to produce a better flower.
By bulking up the bulbs outdoors for an extra year, Mark Eves can guarantee the consistent quality of flower supermarkets demand. And his tulips will flower for years on end when our garden varieties often fade away. The other plus side of removing the flower heads is providing the raw materials for the tulip parade. And the reason our very last commercial grower of outdoor British tulip bulbs is thriving is the scale they can grow on. And to see that, you really have to be up in the air.
Growing for 11 years, so what does it feel like to be up here seeing them from this angle?
It's absolutely amazing to see the colours and to see them all intermingling together. We get the RAF pilots at RAF Marham, not too far away. They actually come over very, very slowly and have a good look as well.
It looks like a giant deck chair. How do you get the stripes?
We're using the latest GPS equipment to get as much in the field as we can. We want to utilise the field to its utmost and all the inputs of chemicals, fertilisers and everything else.
Well, what amazes me is, you know, having been to Holland hundreds of times, this is enormous. The Dutch fields are tiny.
We're lucky here that we've got large arable fields and we're doing horticulture on an arable scale, trying to do it the most economic way we can.
How many flowers do you think are down there?
Millions, millions. We'll probably produce 20 million bulbs from these fields.
Although Britain's down to its very last commercially viable outdoor tulip grower, with production on this scale, the parade's future should be secure for a few years more.